Hi people, welcome back to a new video in Grammar for Everybody. In today's video, we will continue talking about functions of nouns. We already talked about subject and the predicate nominative. So in this video, we will be talking about the direct object and the indirect object. So, let's start. Okay, let's start with the direct object. In a sentence, the subject usually performs the action indicated by the verb, but this action might be directed or oriented to someone or something, and this someone or something is the direct object. The direct object is a noun, pronoun, or words acting as nouns that receive the main action. Here we have some examples. Carlos does his homework. In this example, we have a subject, Carlos. Does is the verb, and then we have the direct object, or the receiver of the action, his homework. You can see we have underlined the direct object. Then in the next example, I bought a dress. I is the subject of the sentence and bought is the verb of the sentence. So then we have the direct object or the receiver of the main action, that is bought. So the direct object is a dress. Typically, to find the direct object in a sentence, we ask the question what or who after the main verb. In these examples, if we ask what or who after the main verb, we get the direct object. Let's try it. Carlos does what? His homework. So, his homework is the direct object. And in the next one, I bought what? A dress. So, a dress is a direct object. So, here we have more examples. She got a new job. In this sentence, she is the subject. Got is the verb. So, if we ask what after the verb, we get the direct object. She got what? A new job. So, a new job is a direct object. Then in the next one, I will paint the house. I is the subject of the sentence and will paint is the verb. So, I will paint what? The house. So, the house is a direct object. And in the last example, I do exercise. I is the subject of the sentence. Do is the verb. So, I do what? Exercise. So, exercise is a direct object. Okay, now let's talk about the indirect object. The indirect object is a receiver of the direct object, and it only happens in sentences that contain a direct object. Here we have some examples. John sent Lucia a letter. In this case, the indirect object is Lucia. Then in the next example, my mom bought my sister a new laptop. In this example, the indirect object is my sister. But why? With this type of object, we should consider two different aspects to identify the indirect object. The first one, the indirect object always goes between the main verb and the direct object. In this case, we have the main verb, sent, and we have the direct object, a letter. So if you can notice, we have Lucia between them, and that's the first key. The second key is that if we ask the question to what, for what, to whom, or for whom after the direct object, we get an indirect object. For example, my mom bought a new laptop for whom? For my sister. So my sister is a direct object. And that's the second key that we can use to identify the indirect object. And here we have two more examples. The first one says, I will give my brother a new shirt. In this case, the indirect object is my brother. Why? First, because if we look at the sentence, we can realize that we have a direct object, a new shirt. Therefore, we can have an indirect object. Then, the indirect object is between the main verb and the direct object. You see, my brother is between give and a new shirt. And finally, if I ask, I will give a new shirt to whom? To my brother. So my brother is the indirect object. And in the last example, I bought all my friends a bracelet. In this case, the indirect object is all my friends, because we have the indirect object between the main verb and the direct object. And if we ask, I bought a bracelet to whom? To all my friends. So all my friends is the indirect object. And here we finish talking about the direct and indirect object. So guys, we get to the end of this video, and I hope that this video can help you a lot. Remember that we'll continue talking about functions of nouns in future videos. So thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.